Hey guys, it's Frenzied, and I wanted to do an EDC update, and I'm going to cover some things that are both with me all the day in my car or just on me. I added a couple things to this just so you're aware of them, and they're not necessarily on my person all the time. I'll just start right here. It's the same Apple iPhone that you've seen forever in all these videos. Something I'll point out that someone asked about once was why the bottom row is blank here on my iPhone, and that's so I can scroll the screen back and forth without accidentally opening an application. So that's why you'll see it that way. Most people will go ahead and fill the screens completely. I just chose not to do that. Same little Leatherman P4 Squirt that I've got on the same three set of keys. And what we've got here is a Boker Hyper that you've seen before. This is my general everyday carry blade right now. And that's because of this. Where I'm working at now, a lot through the week, does not allow firearms at all. It's a federal facility, so even parking on the parking lot would be a crime, actually, with the firearm in the car, the way the law is currently written, I believe. So I don't carry one. So I carry this instead and consider it my defensive weapon, basically. It's a Benchmade 760 LFTI LUM. And the reason I chose the Boker to carry with this is, and I hate to use this wording, but if you're a computer guy, you'll understand, it's the same operating system on the two knives. What we have is two knives that are both tip-down carry with your pocket clip, frame lock design for locking, and then thumb studs for opening. I would not want to, and I do not mix either with knives or with firearms, the operating systems. So that way, you get used to carrying it for a week or 2 weeks or a month or a year or the rest of your life or whatever. You know how that's always going to work. It becomes like a muscle memory to you. But so anyway, we've got a Hyper for just general everyday carry use, pulling out to open a box or whatever. And then this in my right pocket, actually, as my defensive weapon. I don't carry anything else in the right pocket now, just this. My keys go in my left pocket with this guy. And just a quick review of this guy, too, real quick. If you saw previous reviews of this, you know that a lot of people have issues with the Benchmade LFTI LUM here, the 760. For a number of reasons. Number one is the blade detent, which is an issue for some people, and being tipped down is not a big issue for me, though. The other issue that people have with it is you get up and down blade play on it, but and I didn't realize until someone posted it, there is an adjustment here, right there, that if you use one of these Benchmade tools or any Torx kind of head bit that will fit it, you can actually adjust the fit for up and down blade play on this knife. It's kind of nice. I don't know of any other knife that I've got with this, although I haven't particularly looked. But it is adjustable, and you Loctite it into position. If you don't Loctite it, it will drift a little bit over time, depending on how much you use it. But it's a nice defensive knife. I love the look and feel of it. I think it's a beautiful knife, so I am using it. I actually like it so much I bought another one without the serrations that I've been kind of just leaving in the box for now. But I will move to, especially as winter comes on, the serrations can catch on clothes in case I ever did have to be used in an offensive situation. Over here I've got a Citizen's Echo Drive watch. I've had it for a while. You haven't seen it in these videos. It's just one of those things I've forgotten to show you guys, actually. Nothing real special about it. It's got a little battery or capacitor or something in it that stores up light, solar, or energy that hits the face of it here. It's converts it to electricity. So supposedly it'll last 20, 30 years without any batteries. It just runs off of light and saves that juice. And right here we've got the same Expedition Spartan wallet you've seen multiple times. Up here I've got another couple things that you guys haven't seen yet. This is a Motorola device that's used with a Bluetooth link with the iPhone there to create a speakerphone in your car. It hangs in your visor this way, actually. So it's oriented in that direction. And it will allow you to use it as a speakerphone through the stereo system. Or you can play audiobooks or music off your iPhone since it functions pretty much like an iPod. Very cool. I really like that I've got an hour drive each way from to and from work. And so that really fills that hour nicely with music and audiobooks. And there's the other stuff. You can download iTunes, the daily little radio shows that are on there. What we've got here is something else that I've not shown you guys either, and it's just an old set of Maui Jims that I have had forever, basically. I've had them so long that the little nose pieces broke off years ago, actually. I never replaced them, never got them fixed, because they're just so darn light. that it's not even an issue. You barely notice they're on. I'm amazed, actually, that I haven't lost them in that time. And I think it's just because I tend not to take them off. I'll roll them back on my head, on top of my head, when I'm inside a building. So that's the basic kit I wanted to just show you guys. Hope that helps out somebody, and let's let you guys know what I'm carrying. Thanks.